So now I'm at Jungle Park. I don't know if you can see behind me just down there. I've actually walked all the way from the hospital. It's a steep incline. Now you can probably see just into the distance, obviously I got dropped off down by the hospital and there isn't a bus that actually comes up here at the moment. You get a free bus, but that's at the very end of March and I'm here mid-March at the moment. So the bus, you can either get a taxi or you can get a bus to the hospital. I've chose to walk up. I've done this route many times before, but obviously it's a struggle getting up the hill if you're not fit enough. So Jungle Park is just here and that's the boundary wall of the place and there's lots to see in there. There's a toboggan in there, so I can't wait to check that out. At the end of the vlog as well, I'll show you the downhill route as I go down there. You get some fantastic views of Los Cristianos and some of the rest of the Tenerife. So I'm excited to get in there. Let's get in there and have a good time. I've been here lots of times before and it's a really nice city. Yeah, it's probably 3 or 4 minutes to get up here in a car. That's what it says down below, but obviously if you're walking, it's going to take you 45 minutes because it's quite a steep incline. So anyway, let's get into Jungle Park. And just like that, I'm outside, so let's get in there. Now you can buy a jewel ticket here. Obviously you can visit Aqualand and do a Jungle Park jewel ticket, and there's the prices for that there as well. And this is some of the shows available. You've got this one at 12, you've got the penguin show at 12:15 just there. And the bird show, that's really good, that is that bird show. I've watched it several times before. That one is 12:30. And then you've got the sea lion show, and that's 1:32. It's a lovely arena and a sea lion show. And grab a nice ice cream in there like I always do and look out and watch that show. So let's get in there. Now as you walk in from the entrance of Jungle Park just round here, you're greeted by the main arena just over here, and this is where they have the bird show. And there's only one bird show a day and that is 12:30, but I've watched this show several times before and it's a really good bird show, so I'll definitely be checking it out and putting it in the vlog. Look at this arena, lovely. It's a lovely day as well, the sun's out, it's lovely and warm, so let's get around the park and check it out. And right by the arena just over here, you've got some eagles just on their perches just over here. There's one there, and there's another two just over there. There's actually not another two, there's another three just over there as well, and there's a little bit of information on them. American bald eagle. Just over at the guinea pig section, you can come in here, you can take some photos with them, get up close. They're all wandering around. There's a couple in the corner just over there. Yeah, it's a really nice little section there for the kids where you can have a photo, as I was saying, and just have a little bit of a relax and watch them in there. And here we go, over at the penguin section. Let's have a look at this. So you just walk up here and then look over. There's also an underground section where you can see them, and they're over there walking around. Got a nice little waterfall just over there. Yeah, there's a penguin show at 12:15. I'm not going to be watching that though, because you've got the bird show over at the other side of the park at 12:30, so it's one of them, because there's only one bird show at 12:30, so I'm not going to be missing that for the penguins, to be honest with you. But they're not really out today, as I said, they're just over there, so you can't see them swimming around underneath this tank over here. They're just behind that rock over there. But usually you can see them swimming around in there. Yeah, Jungle Park is a really great name for the park, because obviously it's just like a load of jungle around here. You've got these nice bridges around here. This waterfall is absolutely stunning. Let's move on. There you go, Mr. or Mrs. Sea Lion down there. Just getting his fish, or her fish. They do a great show here. I'm looking forward to getting down this at 1:30. Obviously, like I said, the bird show's at 12:30. I can't wait to get down this and watch this one as well, because this is a great show. You can also pay a little bit extra and get your photos taken with the sea lions. It's one of the only upcharges here at the park. Like I said, there's lots of things here you can actually do and get some photos without paying the upcharges. Or if you actually come down to the arena, just down there you've got the sea lions in the distance. Yeah, just before the show, sometimes they sit up there at the top, just up there. So if you actually get up close there at the right time, you can actually have your photo taken with those sea lions without actually paying an extra price. Yeah, so it's about an hour to go to the bird show, so I'm looking forward to getting over then seeing that, but this is stunning, this arena. I've always loved this arena. You can have a nice little ice cream over there, watch the sea lion show, and I can't wait to check that out at 1:30. It is a little bit windy here today at Jungle Park. Look at them down there, just having a swim, all three of them there. Just waiting for the show a bit later on, and look at this big one there. It really is stunning around here, all of the planting around here, and this is throughout the park. It's not just sections. I mean, if you look at this, it's all the way around. Just in the aviary now, and there's lots of photo opportunities in here where there's loads of birds that can fly on your arms. If you just obviously put your arm out like that, they should fly on you.
See.
And there we go, it's on my shoulder. Yeah, I was waiting a few minutes for someone to fly on my shoulder because they're on a few other people's shoulders, but here he is. Give me a subscribe, or give him a subscribe. Yeah, I love this aviary in here, it's nice and relaxing. You can come in here at your own pace and get lots of photos. What I like about Jungle Park is they allow you to take lots of photos, videos and things like that in there. If you go to other zoos all around the world, lots of these things are upcharges, but not at Jungle Park, and there's lots to do here and lots to see, lots of photos, as I said about 5 times. I always do, don't I? It's time to go over the bouncy bridge. Yeah, as I was saying, bouncy bridge, look, you jump up and down on it, it goes absolutely crazy, and you get some great views, as you do everywhere in Jungle Park. Bouncy bridge. And moving on from the bouncy bridge, we have this prickly customer here, Mr. Cactus.
You wouldn't want to fall on that, would you?
You can get really up close to these, but you wouldn't want to get too close for obvious reasons. They're obviously a bit peckish, as you can see.
Yeah, I'm tempted to get up a little bit closer, but I'm not going to get too close.
There's an alligator down here in the water, and I'll show you that now, just down here. Not really moving at the moment, just still and silent. Now this is a great little area of Jungle Park. You've got all of the waterfalls along here, and he is always here. Obviously I've been here 4 or 5 times in the past, and he's always been here. He's always long haired, and he always looks a bit sad, if I'm honest. I've been here previous times and he's always looking a bit sad. Obviously he's been in here a long time.
I do like his bed in there though, and all of the waterfalls, it does look great in there. He's obviously not very happy though, because he's been in there a long time, as I was saying, so he must get a little bit bored for him.
Now, as I was saying earlier, there is a bobsleigh ride here, which I'm going to be going on later on in the day. Obviously, there's a couple of shows first. There's the bird show and there's the sea lion show. And then afterwards, I'm going to get over to the bobsleigh. Can't wait for that. Love a good bobsleigh. It doesn't operate in the morning currently though. That's why I'm going later in the afternoon. And obviously, you've got the one bird show and the sea lion show. So I can't wait to get on that and take you aboard later. So don't tune out. Make sure you watch the bobsleigh. This is a beautiful area of the park. All of the flamingos in there. You've got the buildings just over here. And yeah, this looks absolutely stunning. It really does.
I've always said in all of the times that I've visited that Jungle Park is a really underrated zoo. It's always very quiet here. Obviously it's at the weekend at the moment, so there's a few people here, but normally it's absolutely dead. You can understand why, because of its location. There is a free bus to actually get down here, or you can drive here, you can get a taxi. I actually walked, and it's a little bit of an incline. I mean, it's probably one of the steepest walks I've ever done, but it's definitely worth it, what with all the experiences that you can actually do here. Now, if you're wondering what food options are here at Jungle Park, you've got this pizza place here where you've got various pizzas. You can either have chicken, you've got bacon cheddar fries up there. The fries are actually quite expensive. I find this very expensive here at Jungle Park though. Obviously, a normal portion of fries, €6.60, is about £6, isn't it, for a portion of fries? I mean, where else are you going to pay £6 for a portion of fries? It's quite expensive. So I'll suggest going for the pizza, to be honest, because, yeah. You've also got various ice creams around here as well. Obviously, they do alcohol. So yeah, you've either got this place just over here, or you can go over by the Sea Lion Show. And there's a pasta restaurant over there. They've got various pasta options, a couple of other things. Or you could just grab an ice cream next to the pasta thing. Pasta restaurant, which I'm going to show you when I get over there in a little bit after the bird show. So see you at the bird show. So I'm going to walk towards there now. I've got about 15 minutes towards till it actually begins. Got about 10 minutes till the bird show starts. I'm actually sitting in the shade just over here because you can see it's very hot out there. If you sit out there for too long, you'll get burnt, and I actually left my cap indoors, so I don't want to get too burnt. Obviously, it's different if you're at the beach covered in sun cream, but just get a bit of a relax out of the sun just for a few minutes, and I'll see you at the bird show in a minute.
Vamos a dar un fuertísimo el cóndor de los Andes y el Ápato.
You're watching this bird show, you want to be sitting dead central really, so they can fly over just over here, over your head, and get a better view that way. And there we go, that was the bird show. Yeah, it was a little bit better last time because there was quite a few more birds out, but it's still really good. There you go, look at him there. There were several of these before. There we go.
He's going in now.
There you go. They're all exiting in line. Yeah, as I was saying, I didn't want to put too much footage in of the bird show, just in case you got a little bit bored, but it was better than previous times. There was a lot more of those birds flying around, but it was still a good show, and I enjoyed it. Anyway, the Sea Lion Show starts in about 20 minutes now, so I'm going to make my way over there, get a nice ice cream because it's a hot day, and I'll see you over there. And just like that, I'm back over by the Sea Lion Show. Yeah, there's about 20 minutes to go, 25 minutes, something like that. I'm going to go grab an ice cream over there, but before I do that, I'm going to get down here because Mr. Sea Lion is on the side. Obviously, you can pay the upcharge and get the photo for that. I think it was €70, something like that. I'm not too sure. I'll have to look back on the footage, but there he is sitting up there on his perch. Yeah, I don't know if you can see him. He's actually in a tank there swimming around. There he is. Nice and cool in there. Anyway, I'm going back up now. I'm going to get an ice cream. Need to cool down. I'll just give you a quick view of what I've ordered. I've gone for the banana chocolate ice cream. I've had this before and it's my favourite here. It's really nice. So if you come here, make sure you get the banana chocolate ice cream. Went for a packet of salt vinegar crisp, and then I've got a lemonade. With this stunning view, can't wait to watch this show. Love a good Sea Lion Show. Just going to give you a quick view of what the actual food is like up here. And you've got all of the ice creams down here, lots of different flavours. You've got chocolate, banana, which is my favourite just over there. And obviously you can do one scoop, two or three. You've also got milkshakes, smoothies. It's a little bit busy up here. And this is the actual other restaurant where you can order food. Obviously you've got pasta and things like that, salads. And the food's actually decent here, but I'm not actually eating here today because I'm going out for something substantial later on, so I don't really want two big meals. I just thought I'd show you the menu and the prices. Anyway, I'm gonna have my ice cream now, have a little bit of a relax, and I'll see you at the Sea Lion Show. I'm gonna go to the bathroom.
some footage there of the sea lion show. I really enjoyed that. It's a good little show, obviously. It's a fantastic arena as well. Lovely ice cream up there, food wise. And yeah, I highly recommend coming here. Make sure you don't miss this one because of the surroundings as well. It's absolutely stunning. Just make sure you get that banana ice cream. When you exit the sea lion show just around here, you're greeted by a stunning area again where the monkeys are. And look at this, all of the trees, all of the planting around here. You can't really see the monkeys at the moment because there's lots of places where they can go. They're probably having a little relax somewhere out of the sun, I'm guessing, but this is absolutely stunning. It's always one of my favourite areas when coming to Jungle Park. Well, I said they were hiding. You can see it's just gone in there. They probably ran the back earlier. There's a couple of them, but yeah, they're around the other side and there they are. And just on the other side of the monkeys, you've got this huge waterfall here. All of the rock work. Look at this up close. Absolutely stunning waterfall. Just over at the other side of the rock work and the waterfall now. Yeah, you can actually come in here. There's lots of rock work. It's a little bit like a mini Volcano Bay where you can just look out here. You've got all of the lights in there. There we go. Yeah, you can see at the other side when you're looking out, you've got all of the rock working here with all of the light in. Looks really good. Still got my, waiting for my ice to melt a little bit because obviously it's the climate over here. It's actually a cooler day, as I was saying, than usual today. But yeah, this is absolutely stunning with all of the rocks and all of the lighting in here. Not too sure if this carries on or not actually around here. Yeah, it does. Let's take you around and show you. Oh, some more waterfalls. I don't think I came this way before. Obviously, there's the exit just over there. Normally, I always come out the same way. So there we go. More waterfalls. Shall we get round towards the bobsleigh? We've still got to go over towards that bobsleigh. I've been looking forward to getting on it. And there's also a lemur enclosure where they hop on you and you can take some photos over there. So I'm looking forward to checking that out after the bobsleigh. Or bobsleigh, getting my words mixed up. Look at these flowers around here as I make my way over to the bobsleigh. Absolutely stunning all around here. And this is the way, look at this. Orchidarium, not really sure how you pronounce that, but yeah, I'm not great at that. Lots of flowers around here, look at this planting around here. It's absolutely spectacular. Spectacular? What am I going on about? I'm chatting rubbish again. I'm not gonna cut this one out, I'm just gonna leave it in. Even though I'm chatting rubbish. It's that time of the day for the bobsleigh, looking forward to this. Been on this lots of times. See you over there. And this is the timetable for the bobsleigh. I thought it used to just run in the afternoon, obviously. I don't know if they've changed it, I'm not too sure. But 10.30 till 1.30, and then 2 o'clock till 5. And just for your information, you need a helmet to come on here. It's €4 per person if you come here and pay, or it's €3 if you book online. And here we go, straight on the bobsleigh. Looking forward to this. I've been on this lots of times. I can't wait to get back on here. Get some great views up to the top as well. Looking out to the whole of Tenerife. All of the planting around here. Look at this. And you also have to wear a helmet, as I was saying before. So yeah, obviously safety is paramount. You never know what can happen on these, depending on what speed you're going to go at. I'm actually going one-handed at the moment. But yeah, obviously I'm holding my phone on it. You don't really need both hands on this, obviously it's just forward or backwards on the stick. And as I approach the top of the bobsleigh, as I was saying, you get some great views looking out. Obviously it's low-lying cloud at the moment in the distance and I've just reached the top. Yeah, you get some great views as I was saying, you really do. And here we go. Not sure how much I'm going to push this one-handed. Normally I'd have it full on. Yeah, a little bit of brake in there. As I was saying, you don't really need
torn on with two hands really, but you do at full speed, if I'm honest, if you're holding a phone. Haven't got my GoPro on me today. It's a lovely breeze going down here. Let's push the pedal down. Oh, a bit of air time there. Yeah, it's a little bit dicey one-handed. Oh. Well, I've never broke so much, and here we go, that was it. Straight into the station.
Just taking my ride on the bobsled, and as always, I really enjoyed that. You get a bit of air time on there. I thought it'd be fine holding on with one hand, but if you're obviously holding the handle down, you're going to encounter a few problems on there, going around those corners, holding the phone one-handed. But yeah, I really enjoyed it. Now let's get round and see what the rest of Jungle Park is like, even though I know I've been here before, but for you.
I enjoyed that first lap round. So I paid the upcharge. It's actually €4, as I was saying. So I'm going back round again, and I'm going to give you a front-facing POV this time, one-handed.
And here we go, front-facing, one-handed. I'm going to be braking quite a bit, as I was saying, in a stupid helmet. So yeah, bear with me on this. Oh, heavy braking there. Here we go. Woo! Oh yeah. Not sure what the stabilisation is going to be like on this either. Woo! There we go, halfway down. Still going. Broken about 3 times already. Oh. Woo! And there we go, bobsled.
I'll tell you what, on most bobsleighs, I've never ever used the brakes, but when you're obviously holding your phone one-handed as well, you're going to have to use the brakes, because otherwise, yeah, it's a little bit unsafe, isn't it? And here we go, straight into the lemur enclosure, and there's already a couple of them just down here. You've got to watch out that obviously they don't come in the door. And there you go. Give you a bit of a zoom in, and this is the whole area around here. You've got lots of them in here. And I'll show you them up close now. And they're playing with each other right now. Yeah, sometimes if you go low down here, they might get on your shoulder, depending on if they want to or not, obviously. He's just having a nice little sit down. You don't usually get this experience in a lot of other places. Obviously, a lot of other places are upcharges. So it's really nice that Jungle Park does these type of experiences for free. And obviously, it's reasonably priced coming in here.
And there we go. If you get down low like that, you can have a nice little photo opportunity.
Oh, look at these two here, cuddled together, getting warm. It is a little bit chilly out today. I think for them, it's a little bit of a cold one, so they're just curling up together in the lovely warm.
And with it not being so busy in here, you can just relax in here, go at your own pace, which is always a bonus. Some places you go to and it's absolutely rammed, isn't it? So you can't really take any photos and things like that. Yeah, get down to Jungle Park and you get this.
I've been in here for a little bit now, just relaxing, watching them in here. It's nice and relaxing, as I was saying. They were just down there, but now they've moved over there by the glass.
It really is hard to pick out one thing that's the best thing here at Jungle Park. There's so many things you can do. You can come in here, have some photos with these, or you can watch the sea lion show. You know, it's a lovely arena down there. You've got the bird show, and you've got the bobsleigh down there too. I mean, the list just goes on, really. There's no rides here or anything like that, but it's just really nice coming here. It's lovely and relaxing. Like I said, all of this is not upcharged, so that's why I really like Jungle Park. Right, I'm going to get over to the gift shop now, show you what's in there on the way out. So I'll see you over at the gift shop. This one's not looking at me now.
Now, there is a meerkat section here, just opposite the lemur section. You've got lots of meerkats around there, and they're also in the little gaps just up there. You can see one just up there. And you've got a peacock just over here. Let's get over to the gift shop.
If you've been watching my content for a long time, you know I love a good gift shop, so let's get over there.
And here we go, straight into the merch shop. I'll show you what's in here.
Starting off this merch shop, get yourself one of these for $18.95.
Or get yourself one of the smaller ones for $9.95. If you're looking for a notepad, these are $5.95, quite nice.
Everyone loves a good lemur pen, don't they? And that's $2.95.
If you're looking for a Jungle Park t-shirt, then this one is $18.95. Or maybe a different colour one, and this one is $14.95.
and there's lots of toys in it for the kids too.
The toys include dinosaur eggs, they're $8.95. You've got a super 3D puzzle there. What else have we got? We've got a medical setup here, it's a little bit different, and that one is $21.95. I was going to say $24.95. This one's $24.95, and that one is a care set. It's interesting. Let's have a little bit of a look at this. Interesting. If you like keychains, there's lots in here, and they are all $3.95 each. Lots to choose from. And then if it's a hot day and you're really thirsty, you've got the drinks, you've got ice creams over there. More fridge magnets just over here. If you're looking for a nice fridge magnet, let's have a look what we got. We got some of these sand type ones over here. And they're all £5, $5, €5 each. I was going to say two different currencies then.
I was saying about three different currencies then, wasn't I?
And finally, not a badly priced cap. This one is €3, not bad at all. Well, you've got the orange one here, and that one's €3 too.
And there we go, that was the merch tour. Love a good merch tour, don't I? So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to get down the hill a little bit, show you the route that I actually come. I mean, if you do actually want to walk here, you'll be able to see obviously how I got here, and it was quite a route. It really was.
So Jungle Park's just over here. Obviously, I come from just down there. And all of these views all the way down there, you can see I'm walking all the way down here. You can see in the distance, give you a bit of a zoom in, you've got Los Cristianos, and that's where I'm staying at the moment. So it's an absolute trek, it really is, up to here. I'm actually going to be walking downhill to the hospital down there. It's not that long, to be fair, if you're walking down here. If you're walking uphill all the time, then it is it's major work, to be honest. I wasn't actually puffed out or anything the whole way up at all, actually, which surprised me. I was actually enjoying it. I was enjoying the views and everything. It's a lot nicer and it's a lot cooler now as well. Obviously, it's late afternoon now. Better move out the road as well. Yeah, there's no actual pavements around here, so you obviously have to watch out what you're doing as well if you are walking down here. You could get a taxi, as I was saying, but you're probably looking at about €20, something like that, each way. And I'm happy just to walk and soak in those views. I mean, look at that.
So what did I actually think of Jungle Park? Well, I always visit Jungle Park because it's probably my favourite zoo in the whole world. It's not the prettiest zoo in the world. I mean, there's Loro Park. I like SeaWorld as well. But what it does offer you is a lot in there. You've got lots of things included in the price. You've got the birds. All of those exclusive things that you can actually do and have pictures with all of the animals. You don't really get that anywhere else, do you? You have to pay a lot of upcharges. That's pretty much why I like Jungle Park, really. And you've also got the toboggan that I really enjoyed. Obviously, I went on there twice. I paid the upcharge for it. I actually said if you actually book it online, it's €3. It's not. It's four whether you go and book it online or whether you pay in cash. So €4, just a little tip for you. And not only is it €4, you have to pay that in cash. So make sure you bring some cash with you because you don't want to miss that. If you enjoyed this video, as always, please give me a like and leave me a comment. Have you visited Jungle Park before? What's your favourite thing here? Are you going to be visiting in the future? Let me know. Let me know in the comments, and I'll see you in the next theme parks and attractions video. Stunning views, aren't they? And if you're more of a theme park fan than a zoo fan, I've got lots of theme park stuff coming up. Lots of things over in the UK, and also I'm going to be getting over abroad this year and visiting many places. So make sure you give me a subscribe for all that content, commenting on theme parks and attractions. See you soon. Well, change of plan. I'm not getting a bus. I'm actually walking all the way down. There's the hospital over there where the bus dropped me off. But I'm walking all the way down. I'm not going to Los Cristianos, as I said I was going to. I'm actually going to go to Playa Las Americas, and I'm going to go to the Palms Chippy, because I fancy the Palms Chippy for dinner. So, see you in the next one. I tell you what, not many people would walk this route, so make sure you give me a thumbs up for that. See you in the next one. The vlog is definitely over now.